is everything when it comes to prophecy and the fulfillment of prophecy. In fact, I'll go as far as to say it's probably the most important thing, most important factor in regard to you getting to the right place at the right time for the right reason at the right season. You know, if you move ahead of God, you're on a fool's errand. Why do I say that? Because if we go back to the children in the wilderness of Israel, and what took place there was a pillar of cloud and a pillar of fire. When the cloud moved, they had to move. When it stopped, it was really the presence of God stopping, or the providence of God stopping. It was stationary for a season. It could have been for days. They all had to wait there. Nobody went ahead of God's cloud of providence and direction, because he would have to take care of them. And there's a reason why it stopped and was stationary for a while. So it is with you. God had given the children of Israel a word from him. And that word was that he was going to take them to possess land. Now, obviously, God had a timing to that. He'd spoken to Abraham many, many years before and said to him, after 400 years. Now, remember, there's a time he's placed on that. So when they were in the wilderness, you've got to understand, they were at God's pace and timing. Now, what happened was the cloud would move, they would move. Maybe they just had dinner and they slept, and 4 o'clock in the morning, somebody would shout, "The cloud is moving, let's get going." They'd have to get up, wash, and follow the cloud. That's the reality of it. We have a cloud. When God, a pillar of fire, and a cloud that leads us, if I could use that so loosely, when God gives us a prophetic word, that's what you got to keep your eye on, is the cloud of God's direction and providence. Is it tarrying? If it does, then you tarry until it moves. That's important to know. So God was on a timeline, an agenda. So when they stopped, there was a reason for him stopping. And when they moved, there was a reason, because he was pacing them. Here came a problem. The Amalekites attacked the children of Israel from the back. So everybody that was old, that was weak, that was sickly, that were in the end of the line, so to speak, when they were traveling, they were attacked. Now, God got upset about this because it wasn't on his agenda, wasn't on his program for the Amalekites to stop the journey. So what happened, and we'll deal with spiritual warfare in regard to your timing as well, is that when it's an attack from the enemy, it's specifically to get you out of time so that you'll be out of rhythm and pace with God's agenda and your destiny. And that's what happened with the Amalekites. They caused Israel to stop, take up arms, and have to fight. And as you know, Aaron and Hur held up the arms of Moses, because when Moses dropped, because Moses' arms were up like this, and that speaks of spiritual leadership, which is very important as well, that you are covered and protected by good spiritual leadership, not controlling freaks, but good spiritual leadership, that their arms are up in the battle so that you can win. If their arms are down, listen to me, in the battle, that means you're going to lose. So it's very important to connect spiritual leadership to the prophetic word that you have, or the promise or the destiny that's been given to you in your life, that there are those that cover you, like I do on a Sunday morning when I pray for the thousands that write in. I only pray for the 2,500 at this point that send their prayer requests. I don't pray for anybody outside of that on a Sunday morning. That means each and every one of you that post your prayer requests on a Sunday morning, you have me praying for you, and my arms are being upheld by my team and by you that love me. That's important. So that was outside of God's agenda, or if you wish, he probably knew about it in his great sovereignty, but let's just assume that God didn't plan for the Amalekites to attack them. They had to stop their journey, which means they'd have to catch up and move on so they could get back with God's timing. When you have an attack against you and there's spiritual warfare coming against you, you've got to realize that it's trying to stop you, to get you out of God's timing. And when that happens, don't spend a lot of time trying to overcome your enemy, because that's a battle that needs to be very swift and very quick. Get it out the way. Don't spend hours, years, months struggling with that battle. Kim, how do I do that? Well, he who overcomes. A lot of times the enemy lies to you and tells you you are useless because you never overcame this problem in your life, maybe rejection, bitterness, or whatever it is that came against you. And you've got to understand, if you labor at that place, you're losing momentum. That's what I feel about timing, and I think that may have helped you quite a bit. What do you think?
Very good. And I was also thinking, Kim, about when, especially when Sunil's up here and he's talking about the prophecies that have been given, and we're looking at signs, and we relate what's going on in the world today and what you've prophesied by the signs that are in the prophecies and the timing of God with those prophecies. And so maybe you can elaborate a little bit on, you know, for instance, the Osama bin Laden prophecy you got way back, and you mentioned the palace.
Okay.
And we knew then when we looked at that prophecy and we, you know, he was killed.
That's okay. A great question.
Okay.
Very good question.
Okay.
Signposts. When you're on a journey and you're on a highway, for instance, how are you going to know? They're telling you how many miles you are to your destiny, what exit to take. You have navigational systems today that can tell you the exact time you're going to get there. That's how brilliant it is. Well, God has signposts as well, or signals, if you wish, to point out something. And a lot of times these are hidden. These are codes. And that's why code breakers are so important, because it's decoding, if you wish, so that you can get to understand. The Osama bin Laden prophecy is very, very accurate, very clear, and spoke about a palace that I could see as I leaned a certain way. And then I had the city of Faiz al-Abad, which came to me. Well, at the time, he was not in Pakistan at all. And it was actually a joke to some when I said that he's going to be captured there. Well, he was, but it was about the time, at the same time, in fact, as the wedding of Prince William, yep, and Kate, which was at the royal palace.
Right.
And so to connect those dots would have taken some genius. Mm-hmm. Even we weren't absolutely sure of it, but at least we knew that he would get captured because God spoke about it. There were also other signals that came at the time. And so that leads you to understand what's happening in the world. What was prophesied about around that time? What would be happening? Well, there were prophecies saying certain things would be happening at the capture or the death of Osama bin Laden. Then you've got to look at those and say, okay, now that this has happened, what's going to take place? The leader the president of Venezuela has just died. And I don't know when you'll watch this, but there were prophecies relating long before that, to that death and what would take place after that. So the important thing is not that he was accurate in saying, oh, the Venezuela leader is going to die. We knew he was going to die sometime. But the Lord said, when that happens, there'll be a breakthrough that'll take place. So these are all signals. Let's talk about the earthquake. God spoke clearly through me and said that that the prophecies that were given, or the judgments that were given by many prophets against California, that it would be literally shaken and thrown into the sea because of its wickedness and evil. Well, in a prophecy I got that said, the Lord said, what they had hoped for and prophesied for this state, California, will not take place here, but it shall take place in Japan. But when that happens, and then you have a series of things that came out as a result of that specific word, where God says such and such is going to happen and such is going to happen. Well, obviously he had good plans for California, which we're now seeing unfolding as well. And for us to say that California is the most wicked place on earth is literally stupid. Mm-hmm. Because go to the Netherlands, go to some of these other nations, right, that have worse things happening, and yet we focus on one state. It's very small-minded of us. Mm-hmm. And it also takes away from the love of God and the understanding that the goodness of God leads a man to repentance. It's very important to understand that. So when you see these signs, follow the prophetic words that are based around them as to, okay, there was an earthquake in Japan. Bad news? Absolutely. But then there was good news about that as well. And we have our dear missionaries in Japan that are telling us the wonderful things that God is doing since that time, since 311. And it's our joy to be able to support Peter O'Neill and to say, you know, we believe in you. We want to support you, because what was prophesied was after the earthquake, there would be an outpouring of the Spirit. Not necessarily something that, see, what do we do is we think of revivals as these big things that are broadcast, these big meetings, but there could be a move of God in streets, in living rooms, in houses that we don't know about. And so, because we don't know about it, we say, well, nothing happened. How do you know what God is doing in the colleges, the universities, in the homes and lives of people in Japan? Because he said, once that takes place, that'd be a sign of certain things that will happen in Japan, in Asia, in the Pacific, and in America, and specifically California. So I hope that answers the question.
I just wanted to take a moment today to thank you so much, all of you who have supported Prophetic Rewind over the years. I have still got so much footage and so much stuff to share with you of my dad, and it's because of you and your donations and your sacrifice that I am able to keep doing this and bringing this to you every week. And so my gratitude is immeasurable. And one little thing that we did was, and we did this earlier this year, was we put together a very special little daily devotional of emails that my dad used to send to all of us, his staff and friends and family. And he called it the Daily Light. And so we put it in this 31-day devotional. And it's just absolutely beautiful. Just to read my dad's words, he was such a good writer and so poetic, but also so anointed. And I know that this will bless you. And so when you give a donation to anywhere in the House of Destiny, but specifically with Prophetic Rewind, click the link below the screen. There's a banner and you're gonna see it there. That is how you get this for any amount. If you have a penny will work, and you can get a copy of this. And it's just our way of thanking you for the years now of support in continuing the legacy of my dad and what God was doing through him. So I won't take any more of your time. We're gonna go right back in, but I just wanted to thank you so much again for your support and your continued support. And there are banners across the bottom of the screen and phone numbers you can call and all kinds of ways that you can continue to support the legacy of my dad, the House of Destiny, and specifically Prophetic Rewind. And I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart one more time.
Come on! Give him praise! For tonight, the Spirit will adjust everything. For tonight, those who said yes but meant no, and those who said no and meant yes, shall be removed. And God said the yes shall be no and the no shall be yes, says the Lord. Come on. Shout! Shout! tonight. God is in the house. Come on. I'm gonna win. I'm gonna shout. I'm gonna win. Praise. I'm gonna praise. I'm gonna dance. Oh yeah. Now come on, come on, come on. Nothing's gonna stop me now. I know I'm gonna take the kingdom. this place. This holy, holy place. Approaching to this place. This holy, holy place.
know what I love about the prophetic is you get so close to the heart of God. You hear His mind, His thoughts, what He plans to do. You know, you need this on a regular basis. And there are millions of viewers all over the world that experience this twice a week, sometimes even more, at my den. And you can experience it as well. I would love to have you there. All you got to do is go to kim.tv. We have so much. We have worship. We have songs that come from the heart of God, prophetic words about things that have not happened yet. That's what we say to the people, welcome to the future. And I want you to experience that. I look forward to seeing you there.